नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स, इंडिविजुअल्स इन देयर रेस्पेक्टिव डोमेन्स। एज आई वाज स्पीकिंग इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो अबाउट सेल्फ डेल्यूजन और डेल्यूजन और ऑर्गेनिक way of thinking which form a part of proponents towards one's growth or becoming near to perfection or near to perfect personality. And I was speaking about spirituality, Hinduism and religion. Now, let me take this subject much further. Let's try understanding subject from the point, from the viewpoint of comprehensive ability in the envisioning of the spirituality objective and subjective aspect. Why should one have that comprehensive ability? What is this comprehensive ability? When I say comprehensive ability, one needs to comprehend his or her actions at every given point of time, at any given point of time. Normally what happens is most of the individuals lose that comprehensive ability this is the edge that an individual gets to find when he or she is pursuing his works in fine arts and culture. This is the best part of fine arts and culture. We need to understand this. That is one reason why that Navaneetha Bhakti came into, Navaneetha Bhakti's concept came into picture. Bhakti Tattva doesn't mean you go and pray to the God by going to temple, God give me this, give me that, pull me out of this situation, help me out, get into this, I am suffering, I need this, I need that. No. Bhakti is all about what is the level of confidence, what is that one thing you believe. We need to understand this. Not everyone understands this. This has to be understood at a larger scale. When I say larger scale, when you understand at a subtler level, only then you can comprehend your actions or your institutionalized way of putting up things. The reason for having that institutionalized or the systematic or the schematic way of thinking is only then, once you have that sense of discipline and once you institutionalize that kind of thought process within your subconscious mind or conscious mind, only then you can have that comprehensive ability in envisioning. Now, so far, fine, sir. You are telling comprehensive ability and all. Now, what is that spirituality concept exploring? Most of us implore on this. When I say implore, we tend to go with shortcuts and we tend to go with uninstitutionalized way of doing things. Because spiritualization doesn't come with uninstitutionalized way of doing things. Believe me, ladies and gentlemen, don't get carried away with people who say that in half an hour's time we will give you self-realization, in 1 hour's time we will do this, we will do that. I have seen many of them telling. For this, from the viewpoint of this, I would want to get one thing into your notice. Please don't fall prey to fake gurus like Nityananda Swami or Rampal Baba or Ram Rahim or these or that. We have many fake gurus. Unfortunately, we fall prey to that. We don't understand the ground reality of this. Let's try being, more systematic and skilled. Real guru or real teacher is very hard to be found and imprecise if you see they don't come out. They don't take any money, they don't advertise. Right? This is from the reality point that I am talking. Now, of the Navaneeda Bhakti, yoga therapy, dance, yoga, meditative yoga practice, meditative practice, practice of dance, be it classical or semi-classical, learning music, classical or semi-classical, is going to really help you to get that institutionalized way of thinking or the systematic or the schematic way of thinking. As I keep on telling you, realization is the cornerstone of tradition. One needs to realize this in and out. One needs to, by all means, in a systematic and schematic way. However, one who really tried to, narrate and say with very good orator, I may be a very good orator and I may tell you very good stories. I may glorify every god and say, "Oh, he's wonderful, he's wonderful, you do this, yeah," and all. But that doesn't really help. Understand this. There is a thin line that divides between experiencing that first-hand experience of that spiritual bliss, that blissful nature which we are talking about is what do you get out of it, and what is it that you have understood sitting in meditation or sitting in doing yoga or doing dancing activity, your hands or leg movements? What is that you got? Have you realized on this point? Have we understood on this point? Till the time you understand this, till the time the individual understand the ground reality, or till the time he or she asks a question to himself, yes, this is what I got from my 2 minutes or 3 minutes of meditation or yoga practice, or from the dance, or from the music. That's when that is the starting point of your realization point. Now, to understand this, one needs to understand the conceptual understanding of evolution of Prakriti and Purusha, or the Prakriti and its evolution. Purusha being the conscious, Purusha being at a consciousness level, who is nothing but, which is nothing but the embodiment of Lord Shiva. Prakriti is nothing but, it is the feminine nature that explains whole of the gamut. In a way, it is an unmanifested primordial matter. When I say unmanifested, we need to manifest on this. We need to think about it from the grassroots level. That is one reason why feminine or stri or women are respected. Understand this. They have the highest level of respect, and on top of it, one needs to understand, during the period of Rutu Parikrama, what happens is, this Prakriti, Stri or feminine or women undergo that regeneration. It's like cleansing of whole of the universe, because normally what happens is, stri's definition or women's definition is primary aspect of the universe in and out, because she is responsible for creating, creation and destroying as well. When I say creation, she gives birth to the baby and she nurtures, she gives milk, and she trains the kid. There is nothing that replaces a mother or the stri. That is the reason why we need to respect parents. Purusha, on the other hand, Purusha or Shiva or Shiva consciousness aspect is, he or she, he takes care of, he is just a mediator, he helps, he shows in beautifying things for this beautification, Prakriti is the mediator. Understand this to the core. And that is one reason why Stree has that innate or by default that nature of beautified sense. They tend to dress up beautiful, they tend to have that by default. We need to respect that. We need to enjoy that beauty from far. It's not exploiting them. We need to respect them. And whole of this beauty, right? During the Ritu Parikrama period or the period's time, what happens is this three or the individual so-called Stree Tattva, what happens is they tend to cleanse themselves within and outside. That is one reason why they don't come out during that period of time. This is the practical way of understanding nature of Stree. Maybe I may be right, I may be wrong, but this is one way to look at, because I look at this way of thinking. So that is the reason why Prakriti, feminine nature, women, Stree, has that highest level of respect. Even today they respect. Mother is respected. Understand this. Now, what are the cofactors that affect an individual from the Prakriti and Purusha point of view? Mahat or Buddhi. This is the first principle of individuation, intelligence, and the discrimination part. This buddhi is again dependent on how you think. When I say how you think, how is the thought process going on? What is the thought process? You know, this buddhi has it's a monkey mind. So what happens is this monkey mind has to be tamed by and large at a highest level. This monkey mind which is there, fortunately for Prakriti or feminine or Stree or woman, it is more easier, because at a very early age they get matured, they are matured enough to understand, they are matured enough to understand how individuation can happen and how to, you know, stay self-sustained or self-reliant. At the same time, they develop that intelligence level to the core. This is one of the plus points for Stree or woman or feminine, which needs to be understood by every woman, every female on this earth. And they have that innate ability to have that understanding about the discrimination part too. and they can take control over the ahamkara part as well. Unfortunately, Purusha needs to practice through yoga, meditative practices, and other means. However, of the Navaneeta Bhakti, meditative practices, yoga practices, dance practice, or music. Dance again, classical or semi-classical. One who is practicing classical dance, it will be more easier for him or her to take control over whole of this. Classical music or semi-classical music. This is where it allows you to settle the ego concept, allowing yourself to be more free from all of these apathies and creating that self identity. When I say self identity, that unique character, which is again divided into two parts, that is sattvic and tamasic. Sattvic again is talking about illuminating your thoughts or activating your highest energy levels and creating that lightness. You know, when I say lightness in the mind, and that is a reason why Prakriti is more stronger than Purusha. Feminine or stri or women has always been stronger, and mother has that innate ability. That is a reason why they hold that much weight. And tamasic is again stable and solid kind of. When I say stable, one cannot be stable at all times. He or she has to be like, have that ability to really think, yes, but stability of mind is required. At the same time, you can't be stable all the time. It's a very highest, biggest statement. One needs to understand the in depth of it. And solid with your thought process. That is again tamasic. However, I will talk in depth in my coming videos. Now, connecting both of these is rajasic guna. Everything has to have that balance. Once this balance goes up, then the difference starts coming. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. When we talk about sattvic also, it talks about mind. In mind, there are two aspects. It works from the two factors, that is cognitive front and inactive instruments. From the cognitive front, it talks about gyanendriyas, hearing, touching, seeing, tasting, and smelling. These are the five cognitive elements which one needs to, and five active instruments, which are karmendriyas, speaking, होल्डिंग, मूविंग, प्रोक्रिएटिंग एंड एलिमिनेटिंग. एंड इफ वी गो विद द तामसिक स्टेट ऑफ माइंड, इट टॉक्स अबाउट फाइव ग्रॉस एलिमेंट्स और पंचभूतास, विच आर अर्थ, वाटर, फायर, एयर एंड स्पेस. नाउ वन में आस्क, व्हाई डिड आई टच ऋतु परिक्रमा और दैट पीरियड्स टाइम विच हैपन्स विद फेमिनाइन विमेन और स्त्री इज द पॉइंट इज ऑल ऑफ दीज दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट स्त्री विमेन और फेमिनाइन has that innate ability or understanding of whole of this gamut of knowledge, that gamut of cognitive elements or the active instruments or the five subtle elements which are called tanmatras, to take control over that by default. They need not practice at all, because universe has already given them that innate capacity to, by default, from the birth itself. And that is reason why they get matured at a very early age. Maturity means over here taking control over the universe or creating that balance effect. And normally what happens is lot of junk is what do a lot of junk is gets accumulated over a period of time in the universe. So what happens is the universe cleanses it. With prakriti or stri, woman, feminine, mother, because without mother or without stri, without woman or without feminine character, no one can be born. Zygote is born from the womb. Baby comes from the mother. And then the cycle of the universe starts moving. Understand this. Such a beautiful way of, you know, way that Vedas have explained this. And in fact, if we really look at art forms, specifically classical dance or classical music, this concept happens. The cleansing part happens by default. Though one needs to understand it from a philosophical and spiritual point of view. That's a line. Understand this. This is very important. This also needs to be understood. And that is the reason why Prakriti and its evolution, I told. I did not say Purusha and its evolution. When I say Prakriti and its evolution, Prakriti and evolution. Such a beauty, you know. And this is the deeper aspect of the study of psyche or the psychosis aspect, which one needs to understand. Even Purusha needs to understand this cycle, which I have explained. Mahat or Buddhi, again, is more easier to be understood when you understand the Prakriti from the Rutu Parikrama point of view. Rutu Parikrama means, Rutu means here seasons. Parikrama means one cycle. It's such a beauty, you know. The takeaways or the pointers from this video is understanding of the Navanida Bhakti, that is yoga practice, meditative practice, dance, both classical and semi-classical, music, both classical and semi-classical again, needs to be understood from the viewpoint of Prakriti and its evolution and its cycle, which one needs to understand. Both Purusha also needs to understand. However, I will explain the Purusha aspect, that is the conscious state. Here what I did was, I have taken Stri Tattva, which is nothing but Sat plus Trayam. Sat here means creating that balance between Trayam, Brahma Granthi, Vishnu Granthi, Rudra Granthi, Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara. So, just try to understand this subject. In case if you have any sort of questions or any sort of confusion in understanding, please do let me know, pass it on the comments. I may have hurt the viewers or the one who is watching my videos on a regular basis. Though I just wanted to explain the practical application and what is the phenomena of Rutu Parikrama or the Stri Tattva as a whole. Why Stri is considered as the divine, or why mother has that highest place. Stri has that highest place. Thus I conclude my video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with one and all. Have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namah.